A chemical pregnancy is a miscarriage that happens within the first 5 weeks of a pregnancy. They're very common. In fact, about a quarter of all pregnancies end before the first 20 weeks. And about 80% of those miscarriages happen early. But just because chemical pregnancies are common, it doesn't make them any easier. Mixed emotions are normal after a miscarriage or chemical pregnancy. While some may feel relief, for those trying to have a baby, a chemical pregnancy can be devastating. And while the heartache of this loss can leave you feeling hopeless, it's important to know that having a chemical pregnancy doesn't mean you won't be able to carry a baby to term in the future. So what causes a chemical pregnancy? During the first 5 weeks, an embryo produces the human chorionic gonadotrophic HCG hormone. This will give you a positive result on a pregnancy test. If the embryo stops developing, your HCG levels drop. There's no exact reason why an embryo stops developing. It could be because of a problem in its genetic makeup, or DNA, or the embryo may not implant into the uterus lining the way it needs to in order to grow. Your odds of a chemical pregnancy increase if you're 35 or older, you have an atypically shaped uterus, your hormone levels are too high or too low, you have a sexually transmitted infection, or you have a thyroid disorder, diabetes, or polycystic ovarian syndrome. Some common signs to watch for include a period that comes about a week later than usual, a positive pregnancy test followed by a period, a positive pregnancy test and then a negative pregnancy test a few weeks later, or a positive pregnancy test without the usual signs of early pregnancy. While you can't prevent a chemical pregnancy, there's a good chance that the next embryo will develop without a problem. Everyone processes miscarriages differently. Don't hesitate to talk to your healthcare provider about your loss. They can also help guide you towards next steps.